Good morning. I'm going to show you start to finish tying a coho hollow deceiver, and we're going to accelerate here. We're starting with a nice little piece of bucktail to provide some structure to the fly. And now we are going to get going. So the very first thing I'm going to do here is add a pair of opposed. These are flat wing saddles, very long, very nice. Then I'm adding two more of these saddles. I want to have quite a few on here, and they're often slightly different lengths, and I think that helps the tips actually flow better than if they're all exactly the same length. So I've actually added three little groups of saddles here. The little super glue to hold them tight, GSP thread, and a little bit of lateral scale. I like ice wing as well, but you may have your own flash material that you like. So now I'm gonna create a little kind of a halo of bucktail. Not tied hollow style, but I'm gonna flare this around the hook shank so it makes a little, it's kind of a little shield that helps keep those long saddle feathers from having any desire to foul whatsoever. A little bit of super glue, and then I'm gonna very quickly move forward here. And I've actually moved my thread forward of that back anchor point. I will spin that bucktail on the bare shank around the hook so I get complete coverage. I don't even need to trim those butts. I will secure it with a little bit of super glue. I'm pushing the bucktail back with my John. It's a real handy tool. Of course a ballpoint pen will work, but these tools are really nice because they've got several different sizes, and you can fit a big hook eye into a slot if you're tying, heaven forbid, jigs. Just a nice tool. So remember, we're using a thread dam, and we're not actually winding on top of that bucktail. A little bit of flash. Now you can add a little bit of flash at each station, or more at one station, or you may use no flash at all. It's up to your preferences. And here's another hollow station going on. Each one gets its own careful treatment with a little bit of super glue, and then carefully folding it back. And I'm working that bucktail. This is not a passive process. You're actually pressing and squeezing and coaxing that bucktail around the shank. Now I'm going with a hot pink as my next to final stage, and this is a hollow tie. My next will also be a hollow tie with fluorescent blue on top of the hook shank, and hot pink underneath. Flare those, wrap back, and you can see some butt sticking out there, but that's just fine. You could finish this with pro-tabbed eyes or pro-sport fisher or any brand of imitation jungle cock. I'm using a Copic marker here to color my white thread, and I can see a little fragments hanging off from my eyes. Here's this beauty in motion. Thank you for joining us. Have a wonderful day. Enjoy tying these flies, and have fun out there. Thank you.